Welcome to Carrollton Presbyterian Church on this, the fifth Sunday after the Epiphany. We're glad to have you in worship with us today and welcome you. There's only one announcement this week. I will be out of office. I'll be on study leave beginning tomorrow, Monday the 8th, through Friday the 12th. If there are any pastoral concerns, please call either member care or the elder on call. If you have any other concerns, please contact the church office during regular office hours. Now let us worship God.
Let us call ourselves to worship. When we look at the night sky, speckled with stars, we discover the never-ending imagination of our God. When we pick those not chosen on life's playgrounds, we join Christ in the ministry of healing and hope. When we set aside the time for prayer as well as wonder, we meet the Spirit who is at our side in every moment. Let us call ourselves to confession. It is in the deserted moments of our lives when we realize how we have failed to love, to act, to be God's children, that Jesus comes not only praying for us, but holding us, mending us, sending us forth as new people. Let us come to our God, speaking of those things we would rather forget, so that we may once again hear the words of healing and hope. Let us pray. In that effort to cross the finish line of achievement, always listening, God, we know we have rushed by those we could have stopped to help. In our attempts to climb the ladder of success, we know we have pushed past those who were too weary to continue and we're looking for encouragement. In our channel surfing for the next big thing, the new guru, the bestseller which would change our lives, we pass over that quiet place where we could listen to your heart and find our true home. Forgive us, God, who hears our hearts. In setting aside false pride, may we reach down to lift up the fallen. In letting go of that security which only deludes us, may we place our lives into your hopeful future. In turning from the stress which controls our lives, may we find the one who leads us into the kingdom of hope and joy, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Let us go to God in prayer. Almighty God, from whom cometh every good and perfect gift, and who pours out upon all who desire it the gift of grace and supplication, deliver us when we draw nigh unto thee from coldness of heart and wanderings of mind, that with steadfast thoughts and kindled affections we may worship thee in spirit and in truth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, open our eyes, illumine us. Amen.
Our first scripture reading this morning comes from the book of the prophet Isaiah, the 40th chapter, verses 21 through 31. Have you not known? Have you not heard? Has it not been told to you from the beginning? Have you not understood from the foundations of the earth? It is he who sits above the circle of the earth, and its inhabitants are like grasshoppers, who stretches out the heavens like a curtain and spreads them like a tent to live in, who brings princes to naught and makes the rulers of the earth as nothing. Scarcely are they planted, scarcely sown, scarcely has their stem taken root in the earth when he blows upon them and they wither, and the tempest carries them off like stubble. To whom then will you compare me? Or who is my equal, says the Holy One? Lift up your eyes on high and see. Who created these? He who brings out their hosts and numbers them, calling them all by name, because he is great in strength, mighty in power. No one is missing. Why do you say, O Jacob, and speak, O Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord, and my right is disregarded by my God? Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Thank you. Our second scripture reading this morning comes from the Gospel of Mark, the first chapter, verses 29 through 39. As soon as they left the synagogue, they entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Now Simon's mother-in-law was in bed with a fever, and they told him about her at once. He came and took her by the hand and lifted her up. Then the fever left her, and she began to serve them. That evening at sunset, they brought to him all who were sick or possessed with demons. The whole city was gathered around the door, and he cured many who were sick with various diseases and cast out many demons. And he would not permit the demons to speak because they knew him. In the morning, while it was still very dark, he got up and went out to a deserted place, and there he prayed. And Simon and his companions hunted for him. When they found him, they said to him, "Everyone is searching for you." He answered, "Let us go on to the neighboring towns, so that I may proclaim the message there also. That is what I came out to do." And he went throughout Galilee, proclaiming the message in their synagogues and casting out demons. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Have you ever had one of those weeks, you know, where things keep piling on top of each other? At the end of the day, you're exhausted and worn down. It's been kind of one of those weeks for Denise and I. But we actually have been able to find some Sabbath time to rest, to refresh, which is so important. And especially now, as we continue this journey through the pandemic, as we, all of us, suffering from some sort of pandemic fatigue, Zoom fatigue, computer fatigue, isolation and loneliness fatigue. There's a lot that can and does weigh our spirit and our soul down. In fact, in class this last week, one of my co-students who was supposed to be leading discussions in our small group wasn't able to. Life simply became overwhelming. She lost a dear friend and mentor to COVID. She lost her niece and her niece's companion to suicide. She was overwhelmed, and she needed to take some time to step back. But even when we were in the class, in Zoom class on Tuesday, you could see the weariness in her face and in her eyes. We've experienced the same weariness, overwhelming in our own hearts, after receiving the news that a very dear friend of ours, who's known Denise for almost as long as Denise lived in Mobile, passed away after a long battle with cancer. There are times when you wonder, how much, oh Lord, why are you ignoring me? Why are you abandoning me? That's what Isaiah was talking to the people about, the message he was bringing from God. And I think it's quite appropriate, at least for us, for Denise and I, to hear this message today. Isaiah begins this portion of the scripture saying, "Have you not known? Have you not heard? Has it not been told to you from the beginning? Have you not understood from the foundation of the earth?" And then goes on to describe God and all God's glory and power and strength and majesty. Talking about the God who created everything. And then talking about how insignificant mortal beings are. He brings down the rulers, makes them nothing. Scarcely are they planted, scarcely sown, scarcely is their stem taken root in the earth, when he blows upon them and they wither. That's sort of a reality check for us. I take it as a reality check when I'm complaining, when I'm angry, that the world isn't all about me, that it's about something far greater. And so God asks those who are complaining, those who are wondering, to whom then will you compare me, or who is my equal? Well, of course, the answer, as we look up to God's creation, look up to the sky at night, look at the beautiful surroundings, we know the answer. We cannot compare God with anything. God is beyond compare. God knows the names of the stars, the names of the animals. God knows us. In fact, Jesus says he even knows the hairs of our head and counts them. For some of us, it's not much of a counting. For others, there's more to count. But when you're, if you stop with that message, you're left feeling insignificant, abandoned, alone. But we don't stop there. Remember, Isaiah was talking to a people in exile, and they were beginning to hope that they might leave exile in Babylon and return home. But they didn't know yet, and they were grumbling. God reminds the people through Isaiah's words, have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not grow faint or weary and strengthens. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even youths will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not be faint. This particular passage of scripture is often used in funerals, memorial services, gravesides. It's a promise to those who are overwhelmed. Overwhelmed by grief, overwhelmed by circumstances, wondering if they had the energy to go on. God promises through Isaiah, we will have that energy, we will have that strength to go on. And of course, who is the fulfillment of that promise? Our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And so we turn to Mark's gospel in the reading for today. Immediately following that interesting day, the synagogue in Capernaum, where Jesus was challenged by the scribes, where people were amazed that something of this stature could come from Nazareth, after dealing with the demons and casting them out, they go to Simon and Andrew's home with James and John. And even though Jesus thought, maybe I'm going to get some respite, maybe I'll have a nice quiet dinner with my disciples. Best laid plans of mice and men. They get to the house. Simon's mother-in-law is ill with a fever and in bed. So Jesus, without mumbling or muttering, goes up to her room, takes her in his arms, lifts her off the bed, and heals her. And her grateful response was to serve her son-in-law and his friends' dinner. And yet, if that wasn't enough, after a nice dinner, start hearing noise outside. What's going on? Well, at the end of the synagogue passage, at once his fame began to spread throughout the surrounding region. That's what was happening. People were hearing about this miracle worker, this healer, and they wanted to find him. And it wasn't too difficult to find him. And so, they find him, they bring their sick, they bring their tired, they bring the demon-possessed, seeking healing. Does Jesus mumble or mutter? No. He's ready to offer them healing and wholeness. He's ready to offer him the love of God. And so he does. He heals the sick. He casts out the demons. And shares an overabundance of love. So the people go their way. You see, we've been seeing time and time again how Jesus was ready and willing to heal, no matter what. But even Jesus can get overwhelmed and tired. So what did he do? He practiced a little self-care. He went off early in the morning before dawn to find a place to pray. And that's where the disciples found him, praying. Jesus was taking that opportunity to refresh himself, to reconnect with God, and to prepare for the coming days, weeks, months, and years ahead. I think we can take a lesson from him, as well as from Isaiah. Feeling weary, worn, hopeless, depressed. He's ready to walk with you, to sustain you, to encourage you, to love you. And somehow in the midst of all that, we're able to rise up with wings like eagles. Somehow, beyond all that, we are able to understand and receive the peace that passes all understanding, the peace that is not what the world gives, but the peace that Christ gives. We'll be celebrating the Lord's Supper in a few moments. And in the Lord's Supper, the bread is broken, the cup is passed, and we are offered the opportunity for sustenance, for healing, for hope. My dear friends, as we gather around the table, he's with us, ready to love and to heal. Amen. Please join me as we affirm our faith together. In the words of the PCUSA Brief Statement of Faith, we trust in Jesus Christ, fully human, fully God. Jesus proclaimed the reign of God, preaching good news to the poor and release to the captives, teaching by word and deed and blessing the children, healing the sick and binding up the brokenhearted, eating with outcasts, forgiving sinners, and calling all to repent and believe the gospel. Jesus says, "Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. He also said, I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never be hungry. Whoever believes in me will never be thirsty. Everything the Father gives me will come to me, and anyone who comes to me, I will never, never drive away. According to Luke, when our risen Lord was at table with his disciples, he took the bread and blessed it and broke it and gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened and they recognized him. My sisters and brothers, this is the Lord's table. The Lord Jesus invites you to share in this joyful feast which he's prepared for all of us. All are invited to this table. Let us pray. The Lord be with you and also with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. Praise to you, O God, for all your works. You created the world and called it good, and made us in your image to live together in love. You made a covenant with us, and even when we turned from you, you remained ever faithful. Therefore, with all creation, we sing your praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Thank you, O God, for sending us your Son. He lived among us and told your story. He healed the sick and welcomed sinners. He shared our pain and died our death and rose to new life that we might live and all creation be restored. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Gracious God, pour out your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts of bread and wine, that they may be for us the body and blood of Christ, and that we may be his body for the world. By your Spirit, unite us with Christ and one another until we feast with him and with all your saints in your eternal realm of justice and peace. Through Christ, with Christ, in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor are yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. The Lord Jesus, on the night of his betrayal, took the bread. After giving thanks to God, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And after the supper was ended, he took the cup. After giving thanks to God, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "This cup is the new covenant sealed in my blood for the forgiveness of sins. Drink from it, all of you, in remembrance of me." Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the saving death of the risen Lord until he comes. My sisters and brothers, draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for you, and his blood which was shed for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy are those who find refuge in him. This is the body of Christ given for you. Amen. This is the blood of Christ, given for you. Drink in remembrance of him. Amen. Let us pray. God of abundance, with this bread and of life and cup of salvation, you have united us with Christ, making us one with all your people. Now send us forth in the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world and continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please join me in prayer. Let us pray. God of the universe, you sit above the circle of the earth, and so we pray for the oceans and mountains, inland waters, and the air we breathe. Save and protect them, we pray. Since the beginning of our faith, we have looked to you to gather the outcasts, heal the brokenhearted, and bind up their wounds. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. So we pray for the poor of the world, the sick and the lonely. God, you build up Jerusalem, and so we pray for our country and for all the countries of the world and for all of our leaders. May we all come to see that your delight is not in the strength of the military, but in those who hope in your steadfast love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. How good it is to sing praises to you, O God. We pray for your church here and around the world. Empower us to go from town to town, proclaiming the message of Christ. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Everlasting God, creator of the ends of the earth, we bless you, for you are gracious. Through Christ, with Christ, in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor are yours, now and forever. Amen. Now, at the confidence of the children of God, let us pray the prayer he taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
As we prepare to give this morning, hear these words of grace and thanksgiving. God's love is revealed in those who seek to be faithful in sharing their gifts, so the hungry might be fed, so the lonely might be comforted, so the forgotten will be remembered, so our sisters and brothers might know God's grace and love in their lives. Amen.
Your grace restore where faith and
As we are reminded in today's scripture readings, God is faithful and Christ waits to offer us his healing and restoring touch. May we do the same as we go out into the week and go with this blessing. May the peace of the Lord Christ go with you wherever he may send you. May he guide you through the wilderness, protect you through the storm. May he bring you home rejoicing at the wonders he has shown you. May he bring you home rejoicing once again into our doors. Amen. Thank you.